In year 2000, one of the biggest news stories was the rise of Napster and similar file sharing programs. With these programs, you could get an MP3 version of just about any song you want without shelling out a dime. Suddenly, it was feasible for the average person to gather songs and make their own CDs or compact discs. For which, the sale of CD burners and blank CD recordable discs skyrocketed in the last 3 years. Today, writable CD burners are standard equipment in new PCs in the form of CD drives. Seemingly, in 5 years, CDs will outnumber cassette tapes as the medium of entertainment.
Firstly, the quality that you get on a CD is obviously much better. It's digital. Second is that at the prices that you have CD players today, technically they're much better and much cheaper now. And there's complete interchangeability. The product has a better life cycle, shelf life. And you know, if you keep on playing magnetic tape, which is the audio compact cassette, over and over again, you'll have a problem. Whereas with a CD, you'll have a reasonably long shelf life.
CDs store all files in digital forms, including audio and video files. That is, the information on the disc is represented by a series of ones and zeros. In conventional CDs, these ones and zeros are represented by millions of tiny bumps and flat areas on the disc's reflective surface. When the laser passes over a flat area in the track, the beam is reflected directly to an optical sensor on the laser assembly. The CD player interprets this as a one. When the beam passes over a bump, the light is bounced away from the optical sensor. The CD player recognizes this as a zero. However, the CDs themselves have to be manufactured in meticulous ways for implementing this complex process. There are two ways of manufacturing, one for conventional CDs and the other for CD recordables or CDRs.
The conventional CD is a pre-recorded CD, which people like you and I go to the market and buy a pre-recorded music album. The difference between that and the CDR is that the CDR is blank. So it gives the consumer an opportunity to record or write or burn. These are the terminologies used. Anything they want. So they can mix their own music. They can write whatever they want. They can put music onto that script. They could have pictures, graphics, whatever they want, all on one medium.
For a conventional CD, a CD fabrication machine uses a high-powered laser to compose the bump pattern into photoresist material that is coated on a glass plate. Then, this pattern is pressed into acrylic discs, which are then coated with aluminium to create a readable reflective surface. Finally, the disc is coated with a transparent plastic layer that protects the reflective metal from nicks and scratches. But this conventional CD manufacturing process doesn't produce usable products for individual consumption. In response to this, electronics manufacturers introduced an alternative sort of CD that could be encoded in a few easy steps, that is, CDRs.
If you are making some software, then you can copy your software in a CD and you can distribute in the market in different CDs, right? It is a cheaper solution and a reliable solution for your software. And you can also copy your songs or images, whatever you want. You can copy the data on the CD.
If you're looking at backing up of servers, not talking about the music, maybe a CD rewritable is a better product. But for audio applications, I don't believe that people would be using a CDRW. They'd probably be using a CDR because it doesn't make sense to do a CDRW for music.
CD recordable discs or CDRs don't have any bumps or flat areas at all. Instead, they have a smooth reflective metal layer which rests on top of a layer of photosensitive dye. When the disc is blank, the dye is translucent. Light can shine through and reflect off the metal surface. But when it is heated with concentrated light of a particular frequency and intensity, the dye turns opaque. by selectively darkening particular points along the CD track and leaving other areas of dye translucent, it creates a digital pattern that a standard CD player can read. So, even though the CD-R disc doesn't have any bumps pressed into it at all, it behaves just like a standard disc.
DVD-R is expected to be a big market, but probably only around 2004-2005, because right now the dry prices are very high, the medium prices are very high. But for most other applications, I mean, if you're looking at non-video applications like music, we still believe that 700 megabytes on a CD is large enough. So we think that the CD-R market will continue to be large. Also, the advantage with the DVD-R drive is that it's backward compatible with CD-R. So you'll still use the DVD-R drive maybe to write more CD-Rs than DVD-Rs.
CD burners are an amazing piece of technology, and the inner workings are certainly fascinating. But to the typical computer user, the most compelling aspect of burners is what you can do with them. These days, most burners are packaged with one or more music programs, but you can also buy programs or download them over the internet.